Alrighty, folks, welcome to Crowd Surfing. Hey, we come down to the Wee Beer Festival. That's clever how they did that, right? The Weber, Wee Beer, Wee.
I'm confused. Anyway, let's come down, let's talk to some people and find out what it's all about.
I am here with
Ross Metzger in Ogden City Brew Supply.
So, can you tell me a little bit, because I can't drink this, right? Well, what exactly is you doing down here?
So, we're opening up a new store in Ogden. It's a home brew supply store. We have one in Midvale as well, but we're moving up here. We're just here promoting the new store. So, you take all this stuff and add water, basically, and ferment it, and you've got beer.
Really? Add water, so I can just pour some water in there. And
there's a couple more steps than that, but yeah, pretty much. Just make sugary water, ferment it, and you got beer.
I'm here with
Ben,
Joe,
Sierra.
You're hiding like you don't want to be talked to.
Yeah.
I always make it a point if someone hides, I talk to them more than the people who aren't hiding.
Oh, great. That's awesome.
So, obviously you guys are down here trying beers. Have you tried anything that's like different or new or unique?
We tried the Wasatch Jalapeno Cream Ale. It was different. Not my favorite. I thought I'd like it a lot more, but
isn't it like
interesting?
Like you drink it and it's hot.
Yeah, it's spicy and it's.
So then you want to drink more, but it's hot.
Well, I can take spicy. I'm from Louisiana.
Not this guy, man. If it's more than maybe pepper and salt, I'm done with it. It's too hot for me. Hey, look, I found you're a celebrity of sorts, correct?
What was that? I'm a celebrity what?
You're a celebrity of sorts, correct?
Oh, yeah. That's what I hear anyway. I don't know.
Well, actually, I don't know if you know who the lovely Chris is. Hey, the lovely Chris, will you give a wave? She's totally ignoring me. Hey, the lovely Chris, can you come here, please? She's going to be so mad. She must have had a beer or two.
Oh, a few. Yeah.
So can you tell me who this person is to you?
It's my lovely daughter.
Is it?
Yeah.
How much? Because you would think it would be against the law to make beer.
No, all 50 states it's legal to make homebrew up to 200 gallons per household, and Utah is no exemption. You can make beer here. You can get into it for just $100, $150 or so. Make stovetop beer on your own in your home pretty easily.
So what about you? Are you just drinking? Just
right now,
it looks red.
Yeah. It's the Tecate Diablo. It's got like tomato juice and lime and spices in it. So. It's kind of something that it's got a lot of flavor behind it.
Who came up with the idea of ruining beer with tomato juice? That's what I want to know.
I think it was, you know, Hispanic people. You know, that's my heritage, so.
There's enough malted hops in barley. You don't have to add any more vegetables to it. That's what I think anyway. I could be wrong.
I don't know. It's pretty tasty. It's got a lot of, like I said, a lot of flavor behind it, so.
And you have a wristband. What does it say? Over 21?
Way over 21.
Oh, she took my joke. Yeah. She's like 21 plus like 36, right?
Oh, no, not that old, no.
You know.
Give or take a few. You know.
I was going to say, you know, for a 68-year-old woman, you look really good.
Yeah. I look great. It's all plastic surgery.
Is that what it is? You must have a rich husband.
I do.
He must, you know, to keep you, though, he must be a handsome devil.
He is a very handsome devil.
He's a devil. That's
is he a devil? So, and you can make it more, I don't want to say strong or potent, but you can make it a higher level than...
Yep, absolutely. So any alcohol level you want, any bitterness level you want, if you really like hops, you can add a bunch of hops. If any beer style you've ever heard of, you can make at your house if you have the proper equipment.
I think I want something that tastes good.
Well, that's a moving target, right? So everybody thinks something else tastes good, but if you like Uinta beers, you can make something like Uinta. If you like Roosters beers, you can make something like Roosters or any other kind of beer you've heard of.
So what about yours is empty, but what were you drinking?
I really haven't had much of anything. I'm DD. This is his.
So they brought you to the thing and they're like, have fun watching us enjoy beer.
Yeah, pretty much. That's about it.
You're probably the best person here then, right? Because you're abstaining so you can drive these guys home.
Yep, you know, someone's got to do it.
Are they too much? Are they a pain in the backside or what?
Usually not. It depends. If they've had a little too much. Then.
And look at you. You're coming down here and allowing them to be a pain.
Exactly.
All righty, guys. Thanks for talking with me. I don't know. How do they put up with you? Because I have to deal with you all day long, every day.
And you love it.
This is the lovely Chris that Holly and I spoke of one day. Did you remember that?
I do. I do. Thank you.
And we interviewed your mom one time about a commercial she was on years back. Don't say the name. Don't say the name. And so I'm like, did you get anything free out of that? And she's like, no, they suck. So we couldn't air it. Can you believe that? So the home brewing, how much different is it than, say, the big breweries? I mean, because they got to do it.
Very similar process if you get into all grain brewing as a home brewer. You're doing it the same way they're doing it, just at a very small scale.
You're not making 700 gallons at a time.
No, just usually 5 or 10 gallons at a time. 2 cases of beer.
Right?
Alrighty, I'm here with...
Craig.
Tim.
And have you guys found, like, any great tasting beer you've never heard of?
Is there a beer that's bad?
Well, no, I'm just wondering if there's one you haven't heard of.
No, not really.
No?
Pretty good connoisseur of most everything.
Really?
So what's your favorite kind of beer?
The cold ones.
The cold, yeah. That's not an uncommon answer here.
Right? It's in my hand.
They do suck.
Yeah, well,
they should have gave a free...
A free burrito?
No! Don't talk about type of food, it'll give it away. No. A Choco Taco, right?
Oh, yeah, Choco Taco. Yeah, definitely a Choco Taco.
Alrighty, guys, well, thanks for talking with me. I appreciate it. What are you doing down here?
Drinking beer.
Does your mom know you're here?
She brought me.
Figures. Because your dad knows you're here and he doesn't like it.
Oh.
Didn't your mom raise you any better than that?
I'm a grown woman. I do what I want.
Yeah. Figures. See. So no, sir, why'd you get the biggest beer in the place? They have little glasses. You should have got little ones.
I know, but it's my first one.
How about this? What's your favorite flavor of beer?
I actually like them all.
Just like this guy, as long as it's cold, huh?
Can't beat that, right?
Even if it's warm. Yeah. Even if it's warm. No,
somebody said, like, the best kind of beer is free beer, but I don't know, man. There's some horrible beers out there.
What's wrong with the free beer, man?
I don't know.
I tried to get one here. They're like, no, you don't get anything.
You want one?
No. I get drinking and bad things happen. You don't want that to happen.
Good for who or bad for who? Depends on who it is.
Yeah, that's very true. I never looked at it that way. Yeah.
Right?
I'm here with...
Matt Womack.
Jody Dean.
So, have you guys found any unique beers or beers you've never had before?
Yes. There's been two.
Two, huh? So, and what were they?
Jalapeno cream ale.
Freaking delicious. The huckleberry cream ale.
Really? Because it seems to me like the jalapeno, like, it's hot. So, you take a drink to cool it down, but then it's hot, so you take...
Yes, that's how it is, but if you mix it with a little bit of tomato juice, it's one of the greatest things ever.
So, have you? Is this just a regular kind, or have you tried something fancy here?
It's just regular Shock Top.
Why don't you go get, like, some of these fancy brews? I mean, they have all these craft beers and stuff, and you go with just a standard, everyday, run-of-the-mill beer?
Well, they have a pomegranate one that I'm going to do next.
Well, next?
Yeah.
You only get one, Shaylee. That's it.
I have a bunch of tickets.
Well, you better give them to me. This guy here, what show do you watch?
We watch your show all the time, Crowdsurfing.
That's right.
And isn't it nice that Holly's not here? Doesn't it make it so much better when Holly's not around?
Definitely.
Yes, you hear that, Holly? It's better. You know what? That's a lie, because Holly's great. We love Holly. You know the best part about Holly?
What's that?
She's an easy target. That's why I miss her. I just asked somebody else, isn't there enough vegetables and hops and barley? Why do you got to add tomatoes to it?
Because it makes a delicious red beer. You have to do it.
I don't like tomatoes, though. The tomato juice is horrible.
Yeah, that's your opinion, though.
Well, that very good. I can't argue.
Mix it with Bloody Mary mix.
Yes.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Mr. T's Bloody Mary mix.
Yeah.
You got to drive home.
Oh, yeah, I do. Well, Bill will give me a ride home.
Oh, well, then. You can have one.
Yeah, like, you're not the boss of me.
You're a grown man.
That's right. All righty, Shaylee. Well, you better go yell at your mom for letting you drink.
All right, I will.
All right, thanks for talking to me.
Bye.
No, but really, you watch Crowdsurfing and the Talk Utahs?
Yep, we do.
Right on. Like, you're like, hey, it's going to be on. We need to watch it.
Most of the time, it's like later at night, and we're just flipping through the channels, and it's like, that's the best thing that's on.
Oh, that's great. We like to hear that. So thank you so much. Appreciate it. You know what? I just had a great idea. You know your tomato soup?
Yep. Yeah.
Just pour some beer in tomato soup, and you got it, right?
Got it. Exactly.
Then you're sophisticated.
Then you have it for dinner, too, see? Then you have, like, yeah, it's a meal now.
That's a good idea. We should start a restaurant. Tomato beer soup.
Yeah. It's a way to do it.
It would be the number one seller.
Yeah, I'm sure it would.
It would.
Alrighty, guys. Well, thank you so much for talking with me.
Well, thank you.
Alrighty, I'm here with...
Dave Gibson.
Colby Budge.
And I ask everybody, hey, what are you doing down here? But it's obviously what you're doing, right?
Souvenir shopping.
Yeah. So have you guys ran into a particular beer you haven't liked or liked? Or?
No, they've all been delicious beers. Yeah, they have. They're all good.
A friend of mine had like a chocolate one, but it kind of tastes like coffee to me, and I'm not a coffee fan.
Oh, it must have been like a darker beer. Darker beers have a chocolate taste.
I'm here with
Carrie Miller.
And you found any new, unique beers you've never had before?
Yeah, I have. We've tried that grapefruit one, and yep. And then the other one was the jalapeno cream ale, which was pretty good.
You're like the third person to talk about that. It must be good, but I think it makes no sense because it's hot.
It really isn't. It's not spicy. You can taste the jalapeno, but it's not hot like you would think it would be.
I'm kind of a sissy. Like, if it's more than salt and pepper, it's too hot for me.
Well, I guess it's acquired taste then.
It must be. That, or I just need to stop being a sissy.
Yep, that's true. Buck up a little bit.
A little bit, I need to, huh?
Yep.
Okay, I'm here with
Ellie.
Tawny.
So the question I have is, you guys found any like unique beers that you've never heard of or tried before?
No, I've tried them all.
You just started at one end and just went down the line, is that?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
and that's what you did as well?
Yeah, we've been going together pretty much.
Really? So, but you got a ride, right? So that's no big deal. You can drink as much as you want.
Pretty much, yeah.
And, she said it was a chocolate ale or something. I was like, it's like I'm chewing on coffee beans.
Yeah, it's like, that's what I drink for breakfast. So.
Oh, you know you're a raging alcoholic when you get up in the morning and reach for coffee beer.
Judge Dave.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, man.
He likes a drink in the morning.
Like have an apple beer with dinner. It's more sophisticated.
Have you ever heard Hair of the Dog?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hair of the Dog. Just, does every day.
Well, I've heard it's not easy to be an alcoholic. You have to drink every day, even if you don't feel like it.
Well, and it's expensive.
Yeah, it is. I'd have to get another job, and I'm too lazy to be an alcoholic. And are you here with this guy?
Yes, I am.
Because him and I are twins. Look at our shorts. Look. Except he's got those hideous toe shoe things going on. What's up with the shoes, man?
They're comfortable.
Aren't you embarrassed?
No.
He's like, they're comfortable. Yeah, but... So is a pink shirt, but you're not wearing one of those.
Well, I don't have a pink shirt. You want to give me one?
I can't afford any kind of shirts.
See?
You know how I am. I have no money for anything.
Well, you got money for a car.
Well, no, this is...
Car.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't have money for that anymore.
What happened?
I got old and quit my job and...
Yeah, you didn't quit your job.
All righty, man. Well, thanks for talking with me. I appreciate it.
Sure.
You're drinking that red
sick.
You said earlier that you watch the show,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Once in a while.
Religiously.
Really? Well, that's even better. But Holly's missing. She couldn't make it today. But
bummer. She's my favorite.
Holly's your favorite?
My favorite.
Oh.
Interview's over.
No, I really like Holly. And I was telling somebody earlier, the best part about Holly is she's an easy target. You know what I mean? It's easy to make fun of her.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's got that long red hair.
Yeah, and just so you know, we're not married.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
She wants to be married to me. I'm like, get out of here, lady. Yeah. You know?
She can only offer so many times.
That's right. I'm hoping she'll get the hint one day.
One day, yeah.
All righty, man. Well, thank you for watching.
Thank you very much.
I wanted to have some beers, but I don't have a ride home. So, and...
Enough. Okay, you're out of here. You've had too many. No, Farrell, you're out of here. You've had too many. Not too many beers, too many pretzels. Okay, look at that. I mean, seriously. Seriously, he's going to get pulled over for a PUI. Your pretzels under influence. You're done. Enough. Where were we?
I don't know.
We're on crowd surfing. That's where we are. Hey, it's the beer festival.
It is the beer festival.
Oh, really? Yeah. Yeah, and you are drinking?
Huckleberry Cream Ale.
Huckleberry Cream Ale. Okay, you know what? This is incredible because one of my favorite breweries is right here, Shades of Pale. A lot of people don't know about Shades of Pale. Who are you? Fill them in.
Who am I? 5 years we've been around. Started in Park City, outgrew our space in Park City, now down in Salt Lake on 21 South West Temple, right next to Pat's Barbecue.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's a good place to be.
It is. It's
brewery and barbecue.
Yeah, people come.
That wasn't an accident.
Not at all. Right next to the track station, so you can ride tracks down and get off, and you're right there.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I know quite a bit about beer in Utah, but I have never heard of this brand. This is Laughing Dog Brewery from Sandpoint ID. ID is what?
Idaho.
Idaho, right. Yes,
there you go. Yep.
I'm sitting here with Greg representing Laughing Dog Brewery. Tell us about Laughing Dog beer. You've got like what, 5-6 kind?
We've got 3 that we're introducing in the into the Utah market initially. They'll be hitting starting Monday. And we're doing 20, 25 beers a year. We do a lot of beers.
3 things that should not be in beer: Huckles, Berry, and Cream.
It tastes pretty good.
Yeah, I know it tastes good, but it's one of those like kind of wussy beers, you know what I mean?
I'm no wuss.
I'm serious. Yeah, I guess I picked on the wrong person, huh? You having a good time?
We are, yeah.
Yeah. First time that they've held this, and it's pretty successful, don't you think?
I think so.
A lot of people behind you. What have you had that is especially good?
I think the Raspberry Wheat by Wasatch. I like the fruity beers.
La 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 la.
It's the wussy beers, right?
Yeah, they taste good.
That should be their slogan, you know? Raspberry Wheat, a fine wussy beer.
Actually, that sounds pretty good, yeah.
It sounds pretty good.
I understand. A lot of people like that. I personally don't. Well, the reason I know about you is you can get these beers in the grocery store, usually in a big bottle, reasonable price, and surprise, they got a lot of flavor.
That's right. And in fact, we've got a new 6-pack coming out. So in the fall, you'll start to see a 6-pack option as well in the stores.
Are you kidding me?
No. It's good. We just put in a big bottling line, 16-head rotary filler, run about 100, 110 bottles a minute on that.
No. How many?
About 110 bottles a minute.
Oh, my gosh. Let's see. So you could supply my beer habit in like 25 minutes. I mean, it'd be like...
Maybe 25.
We're celebrating our 10th anniversary this year. I've been around for a while, and this is our first venture into Utah, and we're super excited.
I don't blame you. And here's the thing I think that's cool about what you guys are doing is I've been interviewing a lot of people out here, and I'm saying to everybody, so what have you tried that's good? Huckleberry Cream Ale. That's what I've heard. You can go back and watch the video, and you'll see that that's the truth. And these guys, look right there, they are the makers of Huckleberry Cream Ale. What in tarnation possessed you to put huckleberries in beer, other than that everybody loves it?
Well, it's funny. If you leave about a 60-mile radius of northern Idaho, you don't see much huckleberry beer. But if you're in northern Idaho, everybody has a huckleberry beer.
You know the one thing I've discovered about this festival, though? This is something I did not know.
What's that?
Beer necklaces are really not very comfortable.
They are not. I took mine off.
And any sweaty, soggy pretzel is really not all that great.
No, it's not.
All right. Well, look into the cameras and tell people to come on out to the Wee Beer Festival.
Come on out to the Wee Beer Festival.
For wussy beer. Tell us what we're pouring here today. Okay. What do we got?
So I've got an amber ale. It's called Ready to Fly. Uh-huh. I brought a limited edition Zethos X, which is our rotating line experimental beer. It's a white IPA. So it's very tasty.
White IPA. They said it couldn't be done, folks, but they've done it. White IPA.
That's right. Grapefruit tangerine. You get this big, fruity, citrusy note to it.
Yeah.
And then I've got one of our flagships, our original Jack Wagon Wheat, right, which is an American Hefeweizen.
Now, I know you can get the Jack Wagon and you can get the Amber, the ready to fly, right?
Right.
You get those in the grocery store.
Correct.
I know you can
that's
do that,
correct.
Right? So, did they grow a lot of huckleberries in Idaho?
Yeah. In northern Idaho and in western Montana. They're huge.
I know there's a lot of raspberry up by Lava. They grow raspberries up by Lava. In fact, you know what? There's this town up there called Dingle. No. Have you ever heard of Dingle?
No, but I've been to the Raspberry Festival at Bear Lake. So.
Yeah. Well, there's a town called Dingle, and they grow raspberries there. I've tried for years to talk them into selling Dingleberry Jam. Dingleberry, come on. Come on.
Yeah. Dingleberry something.
You know what I like about these people? They've got their same fashion sense that I do.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We've all got the pretzel necklace, right?
And it tastes good.
But you know what I've discovered? Pretzel necklaces were not made for comfort.
Definitely not.
My teeth.
Did you?
My tooth. I did.
Chewing your own?
No.
Chewing somebody else's?
Uh-huh.
That's chewing some out. Uh-oh, we better not talk about that. You know what else?
If it happens at Beer Fest, stays at Beer Fest.
There you go. Except for when it's on TV. I mean, obviously, if it's on TV, something's going to happen.
And the white IPA is actually debuting here. I haven't even bottled it yet.
Debuting right here. This is its debut. It's this coming out party.
Exactly.
Something like that. Did you break a bottle of it up against, you know, like they do with a ship or whatever?
I didn't bottle any. I just put it in a keg and
You broke a keg.
Yeah. I sunk the ship.
What's the one thing you want people to know about Shades of Pale that they probably don't know?
Well, that we make a high-quality product, and we make beer that is very drinkable and keeps you coming back for more.
Yeah. What is it that people like about beer?
It's just easy for everybody to wrap their brains around. It's just easy for everybody to get interested in. And the community around the beer community is just fantastic. Everybody just loves to visit about beer.
Yeah. All right. Why Laughing Dog?
Because it's fun.
Is there actually a dog? Is that like a real dog?
That's Benny. That's Benny. He's the brewery's mascot. He's 13 years old. Yeah. We just came out with his ode to Benny. We have a Benny's Pale Ale that's just coming out.
This is the first beer fest they've ever held out here at Wee Beer. What do you think? Should they continue?
Absolutely, but they should do it when it's either a little cooler or inside something.
Yeah. Is this like
more vendors?
Really? They need more beer, right?
More
beer. Other than that, it'd
be okay. Exactly.
Yeah, I don't know who thought, you know, beer went with heat, but, you know, whoever. Boy, what an idiot. Yeah.
Right? Needs to be ice frosty mugs.
Yeah. He says it's high quality. He says it's very drinkable. Hand me my glass. I don't believe him. No, I'm not. I'm completely unconvinced. I am. Convince me. I'm a non-believer.
Which one would you like to be convinced on?
Which one? I was thinking all of them. Oh, well. Three or four of them. So, you know.
Walk the line.
You know what? I'll close my eyes, and you pour me one, right, and then I'll try it. Are you ready? Okay, I got my back turned. I'm not looking. I can't see this. We'll see what an expert I am. Okay, ready? Eyes are closed. Oh. Okay, let's see.
When you go to the brewery, people care more about Benny than they do anybody else there. So,
does he in fact laugh?
No. The name came from it was an interesting evening where they were trying to come up with names, and there was some beer involved. And as the night progressed and people had a few more drinks and the names got more ridiculous, somebody said, "Look, your dog over there in the corner laughing at us," and Laughing Dog was created.
And there you go,
Benny laughing.
There you go,
Benny laughing at the owners.
So, what have you tried this good?
I like the Huckleberry from Wasatch. Was it Wasatch?
Yeah.
The cream, the Huckleberry.
Everybody is talking about the Huckleberry.
That was pretty good.
Yeah.
Huckleberry cream, they
said. Yes, absolutely. Yep. The jalapeno's not too bad.
Who has a jalapeno?
I think it's Wasatch.
Wasatch has a jalapeno.
That's what I need on a hot day, jalapeno.
No, it was actually good. It had a little spice to it, and it was really good.
It was not good.
As good as the Huckleberry, but it's good.
That's your IPA.
Nope.
That's your wheat.
Wheat.
Pretty good. See? I'm an expert. There you go, folks. Shades of Pale. If you're not getting this product, you're missing out. If you're a beer fan, this is for you. Website.
Shadesofpale.com.
Absolutely right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
I don't even know if you told me your name.
Trent.
Trent.
There you go. Thank you, Trent. See you later.
You're welcome. Thank you. Bye.
Okay, two things. First off, give them a website.
It is laughingdogbrew.com.
And then second thing, how familiar are you with Utah customs and culture?
Well, I was born in Utah, so I have a little bit of knowledge.
Well, it's a strange custom in Utah is to give the interview guy a sample.
Oh.
I mean, it's just been around for years.
There
really isn't anything I can do about
I've
it.
I've heard about
it's
that.
It's really, they consider it, like if you're talking about the Huckleberry Cream Ale, you know, in Utah, they consider it pretty much a custom to give the guy interviewing you a free beer. Weber County lately has really been stepping it up with all the events. You come out here for their rodeos?
Not so much.
Demolition Derby?
Demolition Derby. Is that
fair?
Yes, for sure.
Absolutely.
Kind of stuff. There's almost an event here every weekend, in case you haven't noticed. This is yet another one that they're going to do. If you could have an event out here, what would you do? Huckleberry Festival?
Yeah, that would be good.
More vendors.
Yeah.
Here now.
All right.
Come on, we ready? Get in here. Here we go.
Get in there.
Here we go. I've never had so much trouble getting an interview in my life. You know?
Yeah.
You know what? We share the same fashion sense. We got that.
We do. It's the best fashion accessory that is also edible. It's kind of a thing.
You know what, though? I found that they're really not all that comfortable.
No, but they are edible.
But they are.
And that makes up for it.
I'll tell you what, though. Next time I come here, flowers in the hair. I'm not kidding you. I'm putting flowers in the hair.
It is the most fashionable thing of 2015, besides the present.
Yeah, have a bite of that?
Sure.
I have heard about that.
Yeah, I mean, it's, again, nothing I invented.
Of course not. Of course not.
All right, so let's watch and see if he can do this. Let's see if he honors the age-old custom of giving the interviewer a free beer. Here he goes. You ready?
There's just too many people wanting Huckleberry Cream Ale.
I know, I can see. This is the best scam ever. Here we go. More vendors and?
The Derby.
And the Derby.
I like the street festivals.
Oh, the old Ogden Street Festival?
Yes. So Harvest, the Harvest Festival, that was fun.
The Harvest Moon is a good one. Are you talking about the old street festival in the summer?
Yes.
The day where the tattoo to teeth ratio went right out the window in Ogden?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
More tattoos.
Kind of like here.
Yeah. Well, there you go. There you have it, folks. It's the Wee Beer Festival. Sorry you're not here.
Thanks. Thank you.
You bet.
I needed one of those.
Utah Beer Fest is a wild time.
Cut him off. Cut him off. All right. So what's so cool about the Wee Beer Festival?
Besides everything?
Besides everything. Yeah. I mean, everything's a pretty good scope of the whole thing. But what's so cool? What's cool about beer, period?
Well, I'm actually very new to the beer scene, so I really like everything I try, but it's nice to have a bunch of people who have a lot more experience than I do who can tell me, hey, this is really good. Hey, you probably won't like this yet. And everybody here is super chill. There's a lot of different breweries that are represented here.
A lot of different beers. I think there's probably like 50 different breweries you could get here.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Awesome. Right. Awesome. In fact, I don't know if you know this, but in a Utah custom, you're supposed to give the interviewer a keg. I don't know.
We'll have to work on that. We'll have to work on that.
All right. Laughing Dog Beer, man. This is where you should be.
Thanks.
He's here for the beer. Perry, Catfish Rick.
Yep. Catfish Rick.
He's a champ.
A champ of what?
Fishing and drinking beer.
You're a champion fisherman.
Yes, I am.
Catfish.
Okay, really? Catfish. I mean, you know, I can tell he's a fisherman because he stuck his tongue out. He was like, I'm a fisherman.
Boom.
I think that's custom. What have you had? What kind of beer have you had that's been good, Catfish Ricky?
The Huckleberry Cream Ale and that Schaffer offer is pretty good.
Schaffer what?
I don't know how you say it.
I don't know.
I've tried a lot of different kinds, and I'm thoroughly enjoying all of them. Right now I'm drinking a grapefruit one from Shock Top, and it's excellent.
So why are you new to the beer scene? I mean, besides the fact that you're like 21 years old in one day or something like that.
I resent that, sir. I just turned 24 last week.
Woo! There you go. Really?
No, but I've always been more of a wine girl. Uh-huh. But I figured I would be more accessible if I also drank excellent beer. Yeah. So now I'm
sure you have problems with accessibility. You know, look at this girl. I mean, who would want this girl? I mean, you know, there's like no accessibility here at all.
You're silly.
Nice man right here in the glasses and the hat and the pretzel necklace and the beer. He's at the Wee Beer Festival, the first Wee Beer Festival.
The Shock Top necklace too. They're handing out sweet souvenirs.
Is that right?
Yeah, I got one ticket. One empty cup. I'm about to finish it off strong with a nice gulp.
You know what? Here's the thing. Is that one ticket can take care of that one empty cup thing.
That's what I'm saying. It's like one gulp, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
If you're a real beer drinker, you need to get like 20 tickets.
Yeah, something like
that. I'm just here for the Michelob or the...
Right there. See right there? The Schaffer-Hoffer.
Oh, Schaffer. I thought you said chopper offer, and I didn't like that term.
Nope, yeah. I didn't either.
I really didn't.
Chopped off.
Right, what's the biggest fish you ever caught?
23-pound channel cat.
Really? Catfish like that. Catfish good eating?
Yes, they are. Yeah. When they're smaller.
When they're what?
Smaller.
Oh, smaller. Okay, I thought you said when they're smart, and I was going to go, how the heck would you know a smart fish?
I wanted to fit in more with my friends, and it totally was a good option, because beer's awesome.
There you go.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm going to turn it over to you for two things, okay? First off, you got the camera, you got the audience out there in television land. What would you like to tell them?
Hi. Beer's awesome. Drink local. It's excellent.
There you go.
Support your local breweries. Okay. None of that big chain. Okay. Stuff.
Where are you from?
Layton.
Oh, is that right? Right here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Born and raised. I love it.
Born and raised. What do you do for a living?
I work at Snowbird right now. I love snowboarding, so I'm cooking there to get a snowboard pass.
That's a very smart guy right here. That's
you
got, right.
You got to put your work in to get
That's
your fun.
Right. You single man?
I am right now.
You finding any ladies out here? I mean, come on, let's talk.
No,
come on.
I got a number at the Twilight Show last 2 days ago.
Oh, you did? Did you call it?
I did, and we text, and it's working out all right. It sounds all right.
All right. That's my man.
Yeah.
That's my man.
Boom.
Whoa, we're on TV. Sorry. Yeah.
Cut that part out. They're smart fish.
Cut out dumb.
dumb. Cut out.
Boom.
Yeah.
On that, what would you like to say to all the people out there in TV land? You're first.
Well, we're glad that we have some beer drinking festivities here in Ogden.
Yep,
we need to keep
definitely.
Them coming.
Yeah, bring
we're
it back.
Here for, we're awesome. Here for the responsible drinkers.
We are.
And the catfish guy.
And the catfish guy.
About the catfish.
Man, I'm going to talk to you later about how to catch a catfish. Never done it.
Do it. Good.
Never done it even once.
Catch big catfish. In Bear River, in Utah.
You drive a Ford?
Yes, I do.
All right.
Bam.
He doesn't just wear the shirt. He drives
Ford
it.
Ford High Boy. Ford High Boy.
There you go.
Catfish, Ricky, thanks for the interview, guys. Now I'm going to give you the mic, and all I want you to say is you are watching Comcast On Demand, Wee Beer Festival.
Ready, set, go.
You are watching Comcast On Demand, Wee Beer Festival.
Woo! Wait a minute, I didn't say anything about woo. Cut that part out. Cut the woo out. That was not my instructions. I was very clear.
You are a silly man.
Thank you
so much for your interview.
You want any dating advice?
Do I have any?
No, from me. Would you like dating advice from me? You have to understand that last time I had a date, Jimmy Carter was president.
All right, let's get some old school advice.
Okay, all right.
What do you got for me?
Write her number down so that you don't forget.
Nope, nowadays we just type it in our cell phones, write their name down. Make sure you call it and it rings in their pocket so it's not a fake.
Oh, okay. Man. Now we're talking. See, if I went back out on the market, I wouldn't know any of this stuff. Some girls give me a number and I'd just go, thanks, man.
Thanks,
but there you go. Come on. I need one more tip. Come on. One more dating advice tip. I just asked this nice lady if she wanted to talk about the Wee Beer Festival. And you know what she said? She said,
yay!
All right. You were at the Wee Beer Festival. How is it?
Actually, pretty good.
Yeah? What have you tried that you like?
Well, I'm trying to try everything. I've had Blue Moon. I've been going to Roosters, hitting up a couple there.
Uh-huh.
The Wasatch.
Everything, it
they've
sounds
got
like,
everything
pretty much.
They've got, why
try
not?
Try the Huckleberry Cream. That's what everybody's talking about.
I did. I loved it. It was actually very smooth.
That was a good thing, huh?
It was.
Well, when I sat down, I said, can we talk to you guys? But she said no. She doesn't want to be on camera, so don't film this. So, but you said yes, right? Oh, you will?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Take one right off of there. Yeah. Okay, so I came up to these two nice ladies, and I said, I've got to put you guys on TV, because right when I was walking in here tonight, I heard one of the funniest things, and you guys were involved.
Oh.
And you, so.
Oh, uh-oh, that's
so
never
may,
good.
You may not remember, but I heard it. My wife over there, and I heard it, and it was making me laugh. Okay, so first off, tell me your names.
Crystal.
And?
Spring.
How is the beer festival?
Cheers.
This is Cheers Beers?
Yeah.
Okay, Cheers Beers. And for you too?
Absolutely.
Okay, so I'm walking in and there's these two guys talking to you, right? And the one guy says, I walk past and one guy says to you, hey, I think I should go get you guys a beer. And the other guy said, I think you should go get your wife a beer.
Agreed.
Yeah. Don't try too hard.
Don't try too hard.
Be confident.
Don't try too hard and be confident. Okay?
Yep. Yeah, be ready for a no, but take a yes with
he doesn't
a happy
try too
smile.
Hard. He's right. He takes a yes with a happy smile. This is the guy, ladies, if you're out there. He's
hit
out there. What's
up.
His name?
Skyler Brindley. Hit me up.
There you go. Hit him up. I was just interviewing somebody, and this guy came up behind me, and he did. And this might surprise you guys, but there's not a lot of men that chew on my neck, and so it was kind of a
new thing.
Yeah, where's your pretzel necklace?
I did not get one yet.
What?
I know. I know.
Now, we're not talking to you. Remember, you didn't want to talk on TV.
I'm camera.
That's right. You are off the camera.
That's right. That's right. No, we're not going to talk to you guys.
All about me.
So what would you tell people out there in television land, sitting home right now and not at the Wee Beer Festival?
Well, there's nowhere else. You've got to be at the Wee Beer Festival.
That's right.
Once a year, all that kind of stuff. Make plans
once
for next year.
See? Every year you have to be.
So you are you're trying to talk on TV, and you told me you were not going to.
No, I don't want to.
Are you sure?
Just
okay, we won't put you on TV, honest. Yeah. We really will not do that at all. So you remember what I'm talking about?
Yes.
And I said, if we find those guys, I have got to talk about that. So what did you guys, obviously a bunch of guys are going to come talk to you, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Like guys on TV. No. So what, were these guys getting anywhere to start with?
I don't, no.
They
weren't? No.
And then what did you think when he said, go get your wife a beer?
Yeah, you should. She comes first. Yeah,
Absolutely, absolutely. Ladies.
Skyler Brindley.
Skyler Brindley, ladies.
We'll see you.
Check out his website, SkylerBrindley.com.
It's on Facebook. We all got the Facebook.
Isn't it the truth?
There you go. Dating advice, free. You've got the camera for a minute. Is there anything you want to say out there to the TV people?
come to Wee Beer Festival.
There you go. What about you? I'll give you one chance. This is your only chance to be on TV because you said no.
I don't want to be on TV.
You're not. You're really not.
It's good, yeah. I don't like the Huckleberry, but personally.
I'm with you on that. Yeah, thank you so much because, yeah, there. No, actually, I did like it. Okay, you want a pretzel?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
All right, pretzel, anyone? What would you guys say to somebody that's not at the Wee Beer Festival?
Somebody that's not here today?
Yeah, I mean, because there's people down there. There's people out there on their couch right now that have no idea what's going on.
Right. Oh, they're missing out. They're missing out. This is great. Great. Yeah.
Yeah. What have you tried that you like?
The sociable?
Sociable.
Sociable. That's what we've been drinking.
Okay.
That's why we're sociable.
All right, and it's true. Well, thank you guys for talking to me, and I think I'm going to go buy my wife a beer. She's right over there.
Yes.
I'll be back later, though.
All right.
All right, folks, there you have it. Crowd Surfing Comcast on your man. I'm your host, Craig Bielek, with these two nice ladies. Wait, one nice lady and one kind of nice lady because she didn't want to be on TV. Although she was on TV, I think, more than the other lady who said she didn't want to be on TV. But that's how it goes on Crowd Surfing. Please join us next time. And until then, I'll see you. Thanks for saying hi when I see you in the mall and all that other stuff. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.